My name is Peter Chaikin. I'm Director of Recording Solutions at Harman Professional. Of course, JBL is one of our stellar brands, and at the NAMM show, we're launching the JBL 3 Series Mark II powered studio monitors. You may already be aware of the JBL 3 Series. These are Mark II versions. I'll talk about what's changed and I'll talk about what they are. First of all, they're two-way speakers that are bi-amplified. There's an 8-inch model. New in the line is a 6-inch model, and we have a 5-inch model. And these have about a 90-watt amplifier on the two. This is about 112 and 112 also, bi-amplified. So, and by the way, one thing to notice is that they're virtually indestructible. So fingers and child's toys and other things that may wind up in your control room can't damage the woofers. But really the hallmark of these speakers is the imaging. This is called the waveguide. It surrounds the high frequency driver. And it is a patented technology by JBL. And it's responsible for three things. First of all, much more detailed imaging, a much broader sweet spot, but also greater accuracy in any room and room to room. These speakers will basically sound the same from room to room to room and give you the same mix in multiple rooms. That's because they're very neutral. The waveguide matches the high frequency performance to the low frequency coverage, and what the speaker puts into the room is very, very neutral. So you'll find that they're very neutral, they're very accurate. You hear a lot of detail in reverbs. You can almost hear mic placement. You hear ambience around microphones. Vocals are big and solid and come from the center. And there's a surprising amount of very, very solid low end that you'll hear from these. The port design is also patented. It's called a slipstream port. Some of the things that we added to the new line are, well, first of all, the transducers have been upgraded. The low frequency is a little bit more linear. It means that it has lower distortion at the limits of its excursion. So you'll find that it's a little more solid in the low end than the existing line. And the high frequency, we optimized the damping of the tweeter. We use something called ferrofluid, which is a damping fluid. And by optimizing the amount of that, we've actually improved the transient response slightly. So you might notice that they're a little more snappy, a little faster, and that the low end is a little more clean at the ends, at the louder excursions. That's quite a feat, considering that they were already really, really wonderful and excellent, and people love them. But also at these entry-level price points, to be able to do anything more than that is amazing. You'll also notice that they have a very sharp, handsome look that fits into a broad range of environments. The front is glossy, and then this is textured, and the enclosures are flat black. The settings on the rear panel, as I mentioned, have changed slightly. We've added something called boundary EQ, which optimizes the performance when placed on a work surface or in a corner or up against a wall. Low frequency tends to get a little different when you do that with a speaker. The boundary EQ compensates for that. So with the 6-inch model, with the boundary EQ, they go into a broader range of applications. With the improved transducers, they remain best in class. Now they're even better. And we think that the new look will appeal to a greater number of customers. One thing that hasn't changed is the subwoofer. It's a 10-inch downfiring sub with a 200-watt amplifier in it. It goes down into the 30 hertz range, and it's an extraordinary sub and the perfect match for any pair of 3 Series speakers. And really, shout out to Dale, who's been so supportive and such a great partner in establishing our newer JBL speakers. We're doing great together, and hi to the folks back home.